हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ एनवायरमेंटल मैनेजमेंट। इकोसिस्टम इज़ फॉर्म बाय बायोटिक एंड अबायोटिक फैक्टर्स एंड देयर इंटरैक्शंस विथ ईच अदर। सो ईच फैक्टर प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। प्रोड्यूसर्स लाइक प्लांट्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट। हर्बीवोरस like deer, goat, sheep, cattle, horses, camels, etc. Feeding upon producers are also important. Then the predators like lion and tiger, which also prevent the overpopulation of herbivores. Some organisms are also important, though they are dirty. They are responsible for cleaning the environment. For example, termites, insects present in dung. Existence of human beings is dependent on the balanced ecosystem. There is a mantra of 3J, Jivo Jivasya Jivanam. Jivo Jivasya Jivanam is a Sanskrit saying which means that one living organism makes the living of the others. Prey and predator intersections are based on the above concept. There are different tropical levels in food chain. Are the producers, that is the first tropical level, primary consumers, second tropical level, secondary consumers, third tropical level, and tertiary consumers, fourth tropical level, etc. Now, what is energy pyramid? Energy pyramid is the diagrammatic representation that depicts the energy level at the various tropical levels. There are the interaction in the form of energy and the transfer in all the food chains and food webs. The energy pyramid shows how energy travels up a food chain. Now, this is the food chain. If this food chain has to be converted into a food web, there should be interactions between the different components. Any living organism can be prey to different predators. So moreover, a predator can also be a prey for other. Frog eats different insects. The same frog can be either eaten by snake or by hawk. This food chain is natural. When by any reason there is a decline in number of frogs, the secondary consumer will decline. Due to this decline, snake, which is at a tertiary consumer level, will also decline. The primary consumers, that is grasshoppers, will increase as there is now no check on their population. Due to increase in their population, the paddy production will be reduced. And due to reduced number of snakes, rat and other rodent from neighboring areas will also rise, which are also secondary consumers. So there should be imbalance of an entire ecosystem, and the number of a prey and predator populations will change, and thus the food chain will come to an end. Dear students, observe the chart, that is the ecosystem. It is a part of two components, abiotic and abiotic components. Abiotic components are again two factors, physical factors and chemical factors. Physical factors are air, water, vapor, mineral, soil, sunlight. Chemical factors are nutrients and minerals. Then nutrients and minerals, they are again classified into inorganic substances and organic compounds. Inorganic substances are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, calcium, iron, sodium and potassium. And organic components are the proteins, carbohydrates and the fats. Biotic components are of two types, autotrophic and heterotrophic. Autotrophics are the producers. For example, is the plant, they produce their own food. Heterotrophic, they are depend on the others, that is the consumers and decomposers. Consumers are animals and decomposers are the bacteria. Then animals are classified into three types, that is the primary consumer, secondary consumer and tertiary consumer. Relationship between environment and ecosystem. Everything that is around a living organism is called environment. Environment is the collective term for physical, chemical and biological factors that surround the living organism. Many biotic and abiotic, natural and artificial factors together constitute conditions of the environment. There are two main types of environment, natural environment and artificial environment. Natural environment consists of air, atmosphere, water, land and living organism, etc. So there is a continuous interactions occur between the biotic and the abiotic factor. The science that deals with the study of interactions between the biotic and abiotic factors of the environment is called as ecology. Basic functional unit used to study the ecology is called as ecosystem. A small pond is an ecosystem, whereas the earth is largest ecosystem. In brief, biotic and abiotic factors occupying a definite geographical area and their interactions collectively constitute the ecosystem. Biotic and abiotic factors are given in this chart. Organic matter, living things, oysters, blue crabs, zooplankton, phytoplankton, jellyfish are the biotic factor. And abiotics are climate, non-living things, sunlight, temperature, nutrient enrichment, humidity, and soil. Environment balance is maintained through the other natural systems or natural cycles like water cycle, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, and oxygen cycle, etc. So environmental balance is also maintained due to various food chain of an ecosystem. Various factors affect the environment. The natural as well as the artificial or man-made factors affect the environment. Among the natural factors, the sudden change in the weather and the different types of natural disasters. So the natural factors are earthquake, volcano, flood, etc. And the man-made factors are deforestation, pollution, industrialization, constructions, buildings and roads. At present, there are many environmental problems have been arise due to the various components or the factors on the earth. So environmental pollution is one of the main factor. Air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, land pollution are main types of pollution. In addition to these, light pollution, plastic pollution, noise pollution and radioactive pollution are also other hazardous type of pollutions. The pollution which is caused by natural sources and due to natural process is called as the natural pollution. Example, earthquake or eruption of lava. The pollution that is caused due to human activities is called artificial or man-made pollution. So there is a need of environmental conservation. It's our social responsibility.